Hello everyone and welcome back. I assume that the game time continues even when the game is paused, and in which case the timer has probably gone up for probably a good 20 or 30 minutes maybe, because the game was paused for that duration of time as I was, well, where it's been such a long time since recording, I was just trying to re-familiarize myself with how everything is done, how to do everything. So I was just, checking the files, the video, the commentary, things like that. And I had the game paused probably for about 20 or 30 minutes. So if the game time is higher than what you were expecting it to be, then that's because I paused for a fair bit. But that aside, let's get back to the playthrough. I am on the way to the second Numamon, I think it is. The third and fourth are located in Freeze Mountain, same circuit board but alternative servers, and then the fifth one is located in Snow Mountain in the Asuka server. And this one, obviously, the Boot Mountain in the Amaterasu server. And here is the Numamon. King of the Forest. That makes me suspect that he possibly has Saber Leomon. And he doesn't have any freeze bugs, because all six of his cards are green cards. So if that remains the way, then any program cards he might have, I have the option of using a freeze bug on. And he doesn't have a freeze bug to stop any of my program cards. That might change. Let's see what he's got. Alright. His other cards are all Digimon cards. Should be okay, because even if my Digimon cards aren't enough, I've got an Eclipse Undo and Control Parts, but it's all irrelevant. My Digimon cards are enough by themselves. Now, he's probably going to get his Saber Leomon back out of the trash. But he again has no freeze bugs. I have two, and I have a vicious hacken. Alright, well, I'll definitely stop this. And he's only got one Digimon card. I have an Eclipse Undo, so I don't think this can end badly. Now, he has a Scramble Up, so Eclipse Undoes aren't necessarily going to serve me well, because he can use the Scramble Up to put his Digimon card back out, but I have freeze bugs, which I can stop his beast energy with. And that would be that. You know, something interesting has occurred to me. I've been given these legendary cards, but I don't think I've actually put them in any of my folders, which is strange. Let me just check. Let's see, these are not legendaries. I'd rather not use that. That can come in handy. That can come in handy. Desire access can come in handy. I don't really care about that. I'm not really interested in the legendary Digimon cards. Actually, I don't know, should I add them to this? And this is a bit different. I don't want to... I don't have a great deal of options here. I don't really want any less Digimon cards than I've already got. Maybe I'll replace the control parts. Got one left over. I guess it'll be the control parts again. It was easy with the brown folder because I had more Digimon cards in that folder than the other two, so it was okay switching some of the Digimon cards for the three legendary cards which I chose to put into the folder. With the black and white folders, it wasn't quite so straightforward because I didn't have as many Digimon cards and I didn't want to reduce my number of Digimon cards any further. So I looked at the program cards and I went with the control parts. I think the legendary cards will serve me better than the control parts. And the control parts are blue cards. They give you blue energy, which isn't going to help me when I'm using black cards and white cards. I didn't want to switch the black program cards or white program cards, because that would have affected useful energy points. So I went with the control parts, and I now need to go to the Freeze Mountain, but I also need to change servers. But it's okay, because there's a circuit board in Freeze Mountain which I can use to change servers, and it will be that circuit board which I use when I need to change servers again, which I will need to. Normally I attack with that confusion technique, but I used Giga Fire there. I was hoping it would defeat them in one, and it did. Giga Fire might be a wiser option when I'm up against Ice Digimon. But when I'm up against Digimon who are not vulnerable to ice, then I'll probably prefer the attack which causes confusion. It's protecting me very well, because when they're confused, they generally don't seem to attack. This is the circuit board which I will use to change my server. I'm just looking at where I need to go. It seems relatively straightforward. If my MP gets low, then that shouldn't be a problem, because there's the inn, which is within Snow Mountain, and there's also the North Sector city within both servers. The inn is also in both servers, so if my MP gets low, then I shouldn't have too much trouble resting and reviving. As things stand, my MP is about 2/3 full, so I don't anticipate any immediate problems. If I get concerned over my MP, then I will rest, and that will take care of things for the time being. And I think it's this circuit board here. I just need to if I'm looking at the right map, then it seems that this one looks straightforward. Apparently the Numamon is somewhere up here. It's always worth checking these areas, because there are sometimes card battling Digimon in those areas. The previous Numamon was an example. So I am, rather than just go through in the hope that I will find a dead end which contains the Digimon that I'm after. I'm also checking these areas in search for the Digimon that I'm after. The Digimon who I'm looking to card battle. Not here. Another one of these areas. Not here either. I probably have a dead end ahead of me. I do, but the Digimon should be up ahead. It looks like I still don't have Diaboromon's signature technique. Well, I have to learn it at some point. Champions tend to learn theirs at level 60. Ultimates tend to learn theirs at level 70. But Megas are different. And some Megas learn their signature techniques later than others. But I am going to learn Diaboromon's signature technique at some point. Okay. I'm not going to do anything just in case he has cancel will. But now I will. And if he does have a cancel will, well, he doesn't. But if he did, I would have just used a freeze bug on it. Sacred Spear. That could be dangerous. I'll just trash a couple of freeze bugs. So he's only got one left now. I'm not overly threatened by his legendary Digimon card. I'm more threatened by some of the program cards that he has. Desire access. He doesn't have a freeze bug, that's a good thing. I'll steal War Greymon. I can afford for that to happen. And that's all he's done. So those five... I was going to say those five cards are going to be trashed. No, they're going to return to the deck. He still has no freeze bug. So he won't be able to stop this. I've trashed that one. I'll see what cards this brings me. He only had one Digimon card, didn't he? So, if I get another Vicious Hack in and trash the Digimon card, then he might not be able to do anything else. The other handy thing about these Vicious Hack-ins is you also get to look at what's in their hands. summon Patamon's not going to do much. Those might make some difference. He's got a scramble up, but I have two Eclipse Undoes. Seeing as he doesn't directly have a Patamon, but a summon Patamon, the Eclipse Undo possibly won't send it back to his hand. Let's see. Doesn't look like it. Okay, that takes care of that. So next, it's the same circuit board, but different server, which isn't a problem because I can go back to that circuit board which I used not long ago to change servers, and I will change servers again. And then I will have to, after beating the fourth Numamon, I will then have to change servers once again. But then I will be done with the Numamons. The black Agumons are already done. So, not too much more to do. I will probably do my grinding at the jungle shrine in probably the Amaterasu server, because the Numamon there, I think, get you 299 experience points. The one in the Asuka server get you 222. They will probably be the best Digimon to grind against. You get into battles very frequently. The experience is very generous. That would be the best way of scoring experience in the interest of putting myself as close to, well, putting myself to level 99. And in the process, max out Diaboramon, and also consider Devimon, Myoltismon, Metal Mummymon, and possibly other Digimon as well. In the meantime, let's focus on what's immediately in front of us and just prioritize the Numamon who I'm card battling, as opposed to the Numamon who I'm probably going to be Digimon battling at the jungle shrine. So when I defeat the final Numamon, I will be in the Asuka server, and it'll probably be wise to change back to the Amaterasu server. That way I can then go to the South Sector Amaterasu server and be ready for the Numamon. Looking at where I need to go. Okay. Upwards and right. There are no card battling Digimon in this circuit board, but the reason why I'm here is to change servers so I can then make progress with the card battling. Quite a lot of the circuit boards are directly connected to the same circuit board in the alternative server. Not always the case. Some of them just have items inside of them. Some of them just have Digimon who card battle you. Some of them might just have dead ends and nothing more. Some of them are only connected to one server, but the ones that are connected to both servers, usually the circuit board that you go in is connected to the same circuit board. So, you know, the same circuit board at the same area, the same sector, same location, the difference being the server. I'm mindful of the time. I'm getting close to half an hour. I'm only about 3 minutes away. 3 minutes might not be a tremendous amount of time, but it'd be a shame to waste it. So I will try to at least make some progress in this circuit board, even if I don't make it up to the Numamon. It looks like this is a very straightforward circuit board. It looks like that the only direction is downwards, and I think it's the fourth area that Numamon is on. If we count the area that we, when entering the circuit board, the area that we immediately entered, if we count that as the first area, this area, then I believe it's the fourth area where the Numamon features. I know where he is, and I will be headed in that direction. So this is the second area, and at this rate it's going to be a while before I make it to Numamon, because I'm getting into a lot of battles. Had I anticipated this number of battles, then I might have considered resting, and I'm not happy that that failed to confuse, because it means using another 90 MP. Confused him that time. And I finished him off with a standard attack. Alright, I'm now only seconds away from 30 minutes, so I should probably just pause here, call that the end of the part. So thank you everyone for watching, and hope you enjoyed.